Welcome back. I'm Jay, and on this channel, we talk about all things lifestyle, health, and wellness. If you haven't already, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you know when I post new content and new videos. So it's been about a month since I made a video. I'm really trying to drop like one video a month. And so, I'm thinking, I don't really know what I should talk about. It just kind of comes to me and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna drop a episode about that. Today we're gonna be talking about dating, so this one's gonna be good, but I was thinking maybe I could start a series, let's talk about blank. So like today, let's talk about dating. Next time it might be let's talk about mental health, let's talk about health, you know, different things like that. Let me know what y'all think in the comments about starting a little mini series about let's talk about, because I think that would be good. And it's, we all, you know, I'm about to be 32 next month, young adult, living, trying to just get things right. And so I think a let's talk about series will probably be fun. Now, I don't know what to talk about next, but today we talking about dating. So let's get right into it. So as far as dating, first off, let me just say this. I'm not even really actively dating. It's not like my inbox just blowing up, dates on dates, this and that. But I am open to it. I am in that space and I feel like I'm ready to date. Been ready to date, really. But when I think about dating and where I am in my life right now, it's like I'm just in a whole different headspace. And so I really want to touch on today and kind of talk about what does dating look like as a Christian, man, woman. What does that look like? Because the way culture got dating set up and what you should do and what a man supposed to do and what a woman supposed to do, it's just so like anti-kingdom. It's really sad. Sometimes I look at some of this stuff I see on Instagram and other platforms and I'm just like, people really expect that. For example, the sheer notion or thought that a man supposed to pay for your hair and nails and all that for y'all first date. So you telling me you sitting over there without your hair and your nails done, waiting on him? Like that's what I mean. Like, it's just like, at this point, it's a joke and this ain't real life. And I think what's really ridiculous is that people model their behavior and their lifestyle around the things that they see on Instagram and on the internet. And let's not forget, the internet ain't real. And so if you have, you know, you following these influencers who saying, yeah, he had to buy me a bag to see me. He had to, like, come on, baby. He trying to see if he even like you, if the vibe is real outside of the DMs. Like, let's be honest. And so anyway, dating is just like a big topic all the time, especially in today's society and culture. You know, there are a lot of people who are in happy relationships. There are a lot of people who are married, but there's a good, and I mean a good big bulk number of us that are single. So let's talk about it. First things first, I want to talk about singleness, because what I don't like is the misconception or, you know, the stigma around being single. You know, people look at you if you're single, and like I said, I'm going to be 32 next month. I'm 31 right now. And if people look at me and I'm single and I don't have any kids, they're like, what's wrong with you? You single? You don't got kids? You ain't got no man? Don't nobody want you? You must be the problem. And it's like, that's so opposite of, like we said, what does it look like dating as a Christian? That's so opposite. You know, being single is not a curse. It's not a punishment. And it's not a bad thing. So I really think we need to break the stigma around being single, because, you know, I think if we break that stigma, then we can, as single men and women, learn to embrace our singleness and the fullness of this season and really get what we're called to get out of it. Because at the end of the day, singleness is a season. Just like, you know, whatever else is a season. You know, this is just a season. Some people aren't going to be married in this lifetime. That's just the truth. God calls some to be married and some to be single. But if you're the one called to be single, that's okay too. So let's talk about singleness. It's not a punishment. There's nothing wrong with you if you are single. What you should be focused on in your single season, especially as a Christian, is your ministry. And let's talk about it. Focus on your bag. Focus on getting to fall in love with self. Like, I will say, I've been single since 2019 officially. I have been married before. I got divorced in 2019. So officially single in 2019. And I've been single ever since. I would say up until recently, and when I say recently, I probably say like the last 2 to 3 months, I was feeling like I need to hurry up and find somebody. Like, I've been single too long. Why is it taking me so long to find somebody? And I don't know, I don't really know what the switch was. Maybe just being in God's presence more, spending more time with him and spending more time just getting to know me. That I'm finally at a place now where I'm like, I'm cool with being single right now until God changes it. Because one thing I'm not going to do is force anything. And so I say that to say, don't rush your single season. I feel like I was rushing it. You know, when I first got divorced that first year, of course, I was not thinking about trying to even think about getting her in a relationship. Also, the very next year was the pandemic. So the way dating just changed after that. That was the rise of the dating apps. Now everybody's signing DMs because we couldn't go anywhere. And then it's just gotten a little more weirder since then. But my point is, there was a time in my life where I was like, I'm tired of this. Like, oh, why am I single? Okay, I guess I entertain him. I guess me and him can hang. I guess, you know, just because you just didn't want to be alone, I guess. Let's just be honest. But now I'm like, oh, baby, I'm staying single until a man that deserves my time and that I'm actually equally yoked with comes along. It's just not worth it. I'm telling you, it's just not worth it. So in your single season, that really is your time to get to know you, fall in love with you. You know, work on yourself. We all have been through things. We've all, relationship-wise, life-wise, and there's literally nothing wrong with going to therapy. There's nothing wrong with spending a little time in dating yourself. There's nothing wrong with figuring out what are your triggers, what are your love languages. Like, how can you expect to be in a relationship that's healthy? Because that's the goal. We want healthy relationships. Culture showing toxic, he pulling my hair, I'm beating him. Like, that's not cute. And that's not kingdom. Like, it's just not. Like, you shouldn't be in a relationship where you're getting harmed physically, emotionally, definitely not mentally. You know, like, but you won't even, you'll accept that if you haven't spent time in your single season really getting to know you, falling in love with you, and then realizing what you deserve. Because once you realize that, you're not even gonna think about settling for anything less. So again, get to know yourself, but also in your single season, it helps you get to know who am I equally yoked with. Like, I think some people, myself included at one point, you don't even know who you compatible with. You just like, okay, he got a beard, he dark skin, he kind of tall, okay, yeah, And it's like, girl, he's toxic. He don't even know God. Let's start there. And so when you spend a little time with yourself, again, dating yourself, falling in love with yourself, you realize, okay, what I really need is a man who has his own relationship with Christ, not a build a man or build a woman. I'm not just talking about men here. I'm talking about everybody. You know, like, we're not trying to be yoked up with somebody that's a project. Well, I mean, if I just get him to come to church with me twice a week, twice a month, then he will start to see. No, he needs to already have his own relationship with Christ. And then, you know, because how can he, and I'm just talking about from a woman dating a man, how can he lead you if he's not first led by God? You can't force that. You can't, oh, I'm going to get him to go to church and then he's going to learn. And then, like, no. At this big grown age, at least me, I'm thinking in my 30s now, I don't have time to help you with that. I'm not judging you because you might not be there yet, but that just means me and you not equally yoked because I'm already there. You don't have to bring me to church and get me to, I already know how to do all that. I've already cultivated my own relationship with Christ and I'm fostering that and I'm spending time in his presence and I'm growing that every day. So you don't have to force and drag me to do it. We can just enjoy each other in bliss because I've already done that part. So that's why I'm saying in your single season, take a little time. Because don't nobody want no project. That's not cute. Been there, done that. And so what I've discovered just being open in my own season of being single is that I need somebody that is about purpose. You need to be hungry. You need to be chasing purpose. That way, if you never get married, if you never find your soulmate, if that's just not what God's will is for your life, you will still be satisfied and happy in that. At least I'm fulfilling purpose for the short time that I have here on earth. So I need somebody that's chasing that because that's what I'm chasing right now in this season. I totally and 100% believe that I will find somebody. But until then, I'm chasing purpose. I'm doing what God tells me to do. The Holy Spirit is telling me to move this way. I'm just doing it. I'm trying to be obedient. It's hard, but that's where I'm at. I also need somebody humble. You don't gotta be, I'm not saying you need to be a lame, but dang, like, you don't need to be in everybody's face. Everybody should know your name and your business. Everybody should be able to say, oh yeah, I used to talk to him. I used to talk to her, yeah, he was blah, blah, blah. Like, be humble. Sit down. I need a little sweet man that's just out the way. Like, cause I feel like that's where I'm at. Don't get me wrong. I used to be the one, and if you know me, you know. I used to be the one, baby, we outside, we live, everybody know me, I know everybody type of thing. And I'm gonna always be social like that. That's just my personality. But I didn't have to humble myself. Like, life will humble you. And so, you know, I need somebody, again, hungry, purpose-driven, humble, and then emotionally intelligent. See, let me just say this. And this is probably what most people don't want to hear. But when you take sex off the table, especially since we're talking about dating as a Christian, you realize that a lot of people don't got nothing to offer you but physical and material. They got money to flash in your face. They cute, but that's about it. We need emotional intelligence, and you don't gain that unless you work on it. Things like therapy, things like reading your word. What does God call? What type of woman does God call me to be? What type of man does God call me to be? Not what culture says cute and popular. God, what does his word say? And when you get with somebody that's emotionally intelligent, I mean, my God. I ain't been with nobody emotionally intelligent, so I guess it's gonna be lit, but you want somebody emotionally smart, who knowing when to speak, when to keep quiet, knowing how to, you know, control their emotions, not go off a hinge, not go, you know, people crazy. You cut them off in traffic and they ready to kill you. Like, it has to be intentional. But again, you only learn and develop these character traits through your single season. So stop looking at your single season as just, I'm the only one that ain't got a Valentine. I'm the only one that, baby, it's actually lit when you fully embrace it. And then another thing I was gonna say about just your single season is, just because you're alone does not mean that you're lonely. People look at, I guess, single people and feel bad for them. Oh, she, it's just her. But I be lit. Like, but that's just me. And I mean, just in the sense of, I don't have nobody to worry about. If I want to jump up and run and go, I don't have to ask nobody, tell nobody. If I want to spend, buy a bag, do this, do spend my money how I want to spend, I don't have to think about, oh, but I wasn't going to buy him this. Or I don't have to worry about any of that. Now, again, like I said towards the beginning, seasons change, and that will change one day. When I get in a relationship, there's no room for selfishness. But right now, I can be selfish without fault. It's all about me. All my money is mine. All my time is mine. You know, like, that's actually lit. Now, don't get me wrong. It gets boring at times. Yes, sometimes you want to love boo to go on a date night with, go watch a movie with, whatever. I get that, but it's not like, you shouldn't be waking up every day, oh, it's just me again, I don't have anyone. Like, that just, you have to change your way of thinking about this thing. Another focus, like we talked about our money, get your money right. Y'all ready to date and ain't got a dime in your pocket. That's why you want him to pay for your hair and nails for y'all to meet. That don't make no sense. You should be about your ministry and you should be about your bag. But really spend time in the presence of God in your single season and ask him, what is my purpose here? What is my purpose in this season? What are you calling me to do? What are you calling me to see? What are you calling me to learn about myself and learn about others? All of that is really important. And I know that's big girl talk, but we grown. All this stuff we seeing on the internet, all this toxic, I'm in and out of relationships every 6 months, ain't nothing lasting, ain't nothing. That's probably, you probably the problem with that. You can't blame nobody but you because you haven't sat with yourself and really learned yourself. And I'm speaking from experience. Like I said, I've been married. I've been divorced. I went through therapy. I've done all of that. So I feel like I've done the work. And I've been one that done settled and just let people in my space that should have never had an opportunity to ever say they ever dated me, knew me, none of that. But when you don't really know yourself and you know, you just coasting through life, you know, looking, comparing, whatever it may be, you will settle for things. And so that's why I can speak on this, because I've lived it. And now I feel like I've done enough work in the 4 years now that I've been single where I'm like, okay, it's lit. I'm feeling good, you know. It is what it is. I think another thing before I move on that we have to get better at is speaking positively about our single season. We be so quick, and I say we because I used to do this, but I done changed. We be so quick to be like, I ain't gonna never find nobody. I ain't got nobody. It ain't no good dudes out here. It ain't no good women out here. I'm gonna be by myself. What if I don't find them? Like, okay, you're not gonna find nobody because every time you open your mouth, you're saying you're not gonna find nobody. I have really changed the way that I speak. I'm like, I'm especially as a Christian, like, it's impossible to please God without faith. So if we don't have faith and expectancy and hope that things in our, and this is anything, not just dating, but circumstances will change, guess what? They won't. Some of y'all still single just because out your mouth, all you saying is, ain't nobody out here. You know, that's what I'm saying. Like, we got to change the way we speak. So I've been speaking more positively about it. You know, it ain't like I'm waking up every day like, yes, he's on his way. I mean, maybe I should be doing that. But I know if somebody asks me or if we talking about it, I'm like, girl, I know I'm going to get me, you know, I'm going to find somebody. It's just a matter of time. Like, and I truly believe that. There was a time where I did not believe that. I was like, well, maybe that's just not in the cards for me. I mean, I did already was married once. It didn't work. Maybe that was my one shot. But now my mind has just changed. You know, we have to renew our mind daily. That's why we got to be in God's presence. We got to be in his word and all of that, because the enemy will have you believe in lies. It is better. Two is better than one. Three is even stronger than that. The word says that. And so, you know, it is, companionship is good. God don't want you to be alone or lonely out here. That's not his plan for you. And even if it ain't in like a marriage, he's going to bring the right friendships and the right coworkers and the right community around you to give you what you need. But you have to believe that that's what you deserve and that's what you need. And so, you know, I just think that that's just a good point to mention, that we have to stop talking negatively about just being single or about relationships not working or about whatever, because that's why it's not working. Don't you know what comes out your mouth? I mean, words are just so powerful. They really, really are. Words are just so powerful. And I'm going to give this example as to why I say that. One time I was talking to an ex, just talking to him about something, and he mentioned something. But my point is, I said to him, by the time me and you cross paths again, in so many words, I basically said, by the time me and you cross paths again, I'm gonna be married. And I said that jokingly and, you know, just saying stuff. You know, I'm just saying stuff. I hadn't even met my ex-husband at the time. And literally by the time me and my ex had crossed paths again, I was married. But I was in a bad and wrong marriage. And so I say all that to say, your words really do have power. Don't think that things you just saying willy-nilly and, oh, I ain't gonna be and I ain't gonna find, that stuff don't hold power, because it holds weight. And so we have to be intentional about the things we speak about our single season and the things we speak about, you know, trying to find our spouse and relationships and all that. So singleness is not a curse. It's basically what I'm trying to get y'all to see. It's lit. I'm enjoying myself now. And I at one point I was like, I'm single. But now I'm like, baby, I'm single. And I choose who gets to enter my space. I choose who gets to, who I date and who, you know, I spend time with. I choose all that. And I ain't wasting no time either, because I only want the person that God handcrafted for me. And you got to open yourself up to find that person. But my point is, we ain't got to waste time when we know it ain't going to work. So let's talk about dating apps. Okay, should Christians be on dating apps? My answer is yeah, why not? You never know what avenue God is going to use for you to find your spouse. He can use grocery, knock. Y'all run into each other at the grocery store. The man can slide in your DMs, dating apps. I have so many friends who have met their spouses who are now their fiancés and husbands and stuff on a dating app. So I'm definitely not against dating apps, but I think there is a certain type of etiquette to it. Like, you don't need to just be on there. I think sometimes with dating apps, people can get so caught up in, have I had matches? How many dates have I gotten? And blah, blah, blah. So don't be so consumed with finding people on a dating app that the dating app itself or that experience itself becomes a mini God for you. Because at the end of the day, you should be consumed with Jesus. Let's just keep it 100. That's who you should be consumed with. But in the midst of that, yeah, still date. Still put yourself out there. You don't want to put a wall up because of bad experiences, or, oh, I ain't really matching with nobody, or, oh, blah, blah. that you didn't put a wall up and now you just don't want to put yourself out there. Now you not finna date. Now you not finna be on no day naps. No, no, no. Now, if you in a space where you still working on you and you're not ready to be on a day nap, fine. But if you're like me where you feel like, okay, I've done the work, I'm ready to put myself out there, just be on there. You match with somebody and it's y'all, you know, talk and link and it don't work, fine. Next, you match with somebody and y'all talk and link and it do work, great for you. But you have to put yourself out there is basically my point. But, you know, as a Christian, I don't think, you know, I would say the biggest thing to do in this, well, we talking about Christian dating, is utilize your discernment. Be careful, because at the end of the day, day naps can still be dangerous. Day naps can still be, you know, ways that people can try to trap you. It's so many horror stories out there. So utilize your discernment. If something don't feel right, it's not. Don't even question it. You don't know these people behind these screens. People still are catfishing. If he ain't trying, he can't FaceTime you. Everybody got an iPhone, and you can even video call the Androids now from iPhones. So, you know, different things like that. Make sure you know who you matching up with, linking up with. I think personally, one of my probably best, like, first little link up experiences with a dude that I met on a day nap is he met me at the car wash around the corner from my house, in the kind that you have to put the quarters in. And our first little date or link up was him washing my car. And I was just outside the car. It was public, daylight, daytime. And we was just talking as he was washing my car. And I actually thought it was a sweet gesture because, number one, didn't cost him a lot of money. Didn't, of course, cost me any money. I came out of it with a clean car. And we was able to see, are we vibing or not? Because it's a little different than texting and calling. You know, what you look like in person. Okay, this is you. You are cool. But I also felt safe because, like I said, I'm around the corner from my house. I didn't tell him where I lived. And it's broad daylight and it's a lot of people in the car wash. And so, you know, you can do little things like that when you meeting people on dating apps and linking up with people. It don't have to be, we Perry's night one. We at the steakhouse night one. You need to, you know, like, baby, we just trying to see, can we even vibe? Like, it can be something low key. But again, use your discernment. And the reason why I brought that particular situation up is, although it was a sweet gesture, he washed my car. He was actually really nice and he was cute too. But one of the things he said during that time was, oh, I don't believe in God. Me and you believe in two different gods. Oh, we not equally yoked. Thank you for my washed car. Goodbye. And we didn't talk no more after that because I'm utilizing my discernment. You're not finna be a project for me. I'm not, you just told me we don't believe in the same type of God. I'm gonna pray for you, brother. And hopefully you figure it out before it's too late. But at the end of the day, clearly, me and you not equally yoked because we don't believe the same. And I don't want to be with somebody where I have to force, well, I ain't gonna never force my beliefs on anybody, but I don't want to have to, like, it's a project. And so this is what I mean about utilizing your discernment. If something ain't right, it just ain't. And if you have your non-negotiables, like he needs to be saved, he don't need to have kids, or he, whatever your non-negotiables are, don't make them negotiables just because now you see him and he cute. Because at the end of the day, there's no perfect person, but there is somebody perfect for you. So when you own these dating apps and you meeting these people, your antennas need to be up. Another thing I had started doing too is I pray about the people I date. I didn't used to do that, but if I meet somebody, link with them, especially if I like them, like we link and I'm like, I mean, I don't know. I could see myself, maybe this could maybe go somewhere. I pray. And I'm telling you, it take God no time to show me who I'm really dealing with. And sometimes I don't even be wanting to pray because I already know he's finna show me and then you already know. But I'm telling you, pray about the people you date and bring God into the fold of your dating experiences. Why we got God and everything else, health, family stuff, job stuff. But when it come to dating, we want to leave God out of it. Like God just don't know nothing about that. That's what you definitely need to be bringing him into the fold about. And you know, it could be a simple prayer. God, show me who I'm dealing with. Is this the person you will for me or not? And I'm telling you, like the next day, the man gonna start tripping or the girl gonna start tripping. And you need to take that as God's answer. Utilize your discernment. Okay, next. You gonna have to go through a few little dating experiences before you find that person. That's just part of being open. But that's why I say take things like sex off the table. Take all that off the table so you can see who you really dealing with. Because that physical had you in a soul tie and then you can't even see past what they're clearly showing you. Don't rewrite nobody. That don't make the person a bad person. That don't make the person an evil person or whatever. It just means the person ain't for you. And that's okay. So my advice is bring God into the fold of your dating experiences. Pray about these people, because for me, I just feel like that has saved me so much time, so much time. And yes, that means I'm back at square one, starting over. Yeah, that can get annoying. But I'd rather that than be 6, 7, 8 months in with a dude that don't really have no real intentions for me. I'm too much of a prize for that. Baby, you lucky to be talking to me. So if you ain't got no real intentions for me, I'm not finna waste 6, 7, 8, 9 months. Now you're not even trying to get in a relationship. Now all of a sudden you fix your mouth to say you don't believe in marriage. Now all of a sudden, and I done wasted all this time. That's why from jump, I'm bringing God into the fold. And I encourage Christians out there, as you date, do that. Don't forget God in the most, especially if you know you desire a marriage or you desire a relationship. Don't leave God out of that. You need him in that, because we don't know. We're not really all that smart, to be honest. We need him. So yes, utilize your discernment. Don't get too consumed with matches and things like that. If it work, it work. If it don't, it don't. That don't mean nothing. Because I think sometimes people will be talking to somebody and then get ghosted or whatever. Now they thinking, I must be the problem. I'm not cute enough. Maybe it was me, blah, blah, blah. No, that just wasn't the right person for you. So next, we got to stop letting these unqualified people determine whether or not we qualified. Baby, once you know your worth in Christ, can't nobody tell you nothing. And I'm like so in that space right now, nobody can tell me nothing. If I get matched with somebody on a date nap or it just in life, you know, if I just meet somebody, we pass our numbers along, whatever, and it don't work out, I'm never going to say, well, I'm not good enough. Like, I just don't think that. I'm just like, okay, well, that just wasn't my person. It's cool. But I still wish that person well, you know, unless they did something cray cray. Now that's different. But anyway, my point is, don't waste your time. Utilize your discernment and bring God into the fold, because he knows best. He knows better. He knows who he has you equally yoked with. And so, I'll be taking notes before I do this stuff. So I'm just making sure I hit all my points. And then I think the last thing, and then I'm going to wrap it up, is just monitor the spaces you go. Because there are, as Christians, there are certain places that godly men and women just won't ever go. Point blank and period. So trust me, like I said, I'm speaking from straight up experience. If you know me, you know I was a party girl, going out, clubbing, lit, drunk, everything, lit. I can't be in those spaces thinking I'm going to find a godly man. I mean, I'm at the club, drunk. Like, you know, so monitor the spaces you go to, you know. And I'm not saying you can't go out and have a girl's night. I'm not saying none of that, but maybe when you go out, you're not looking like, oh, girl, it's going to be dudes there. I'm looking. No, we at the club. I don't want nobody from the club. If I do end up, I don't even go to the club anymore, but if I do go to the club, bar, whatever, I ain't going thinking, oh, I'm going to find my man tonight. Because like I said, there are just certain spaces that godly men and women just will not go. And so if you are out there looking, and everywhere you go, you want to be looking your best because you never know, just be mindful of where you're at. You're at the bar. You're at the hookah club. Like, you might not find what you're looking for in those spaces. So just be mindful of the spaces that you go. And that don't mean, you know, people might think, well, all I can go to is church. No, they're all, I mean, you can go, I've been going to Christian, like, concerts, church too, but I travel, you know, I'm just saying everything don't have to be in the space of, like, clubbing and drinking and that type of thing. Dinner, you know, you never know where you can meet your person, the store, whatever. But my point is, just don't get mad if you met him in the club and 6 months later, now you realize he got a baby mama and a wife that he ain't really divorced yet. No, you met him at the club. So just be mindful of that. But to wrap things up, dating is spiritual. It is not, it really is, it's a spiritual experience. It's not a natural experience. So you have to have God in the fold of it all. If we're talking about marriage, if we're talking about longevity, it is a spiritual experience. You know, especially when you throw sex in, you know, that's two becoming one. That's a whole different topic and a whole another episode. But my point is, it is spiritual. We got to quit being willy-nilly about this. We got to be intentional. We need to embrace our single season until the season changes. Because at the end of the day, seasons always change. Seasons are going to change. Your single season will transition into a relationship and hopefully a marriage. But you wanted to do it in under God's will. Because I don't want anything for my life that's not covered under God's will. And so when we think about it like that, we'll embrace it and enjoy it. Because I know at the end of the day, this ain't gonna last long. By the next podcast, I might be like, yeah, I am here. I don't know what I'm gonna be saying. But the point is, this is just a season. And since it's just a season, I'm gonna get all that I need to get out of this particular season. Relationships are hard enough, or they can be. But when we work on ourselves and we love ourselves first, you gotta love you first before you can love anybody else. Then you really can't operate in bliss and enjoy the bliss and the company and the companionship of somebody else. So self-love is key. And then just be hopeful. Like I said, ladies, men, you know, we got to change up the way we think about finding love. Be hopeful. Speak it as if it were already so. I will have somebody that loves me. I will have a God-fearing man. I will have a God-fearing woman. It's all in God's timing. And until he changes up that season and he switches it from you waiting on it to walking in it, you need to be hopeful and have faith. I know that's easier said than done, and it really is a learned behavior, but practice that stuff because I think that'll help you embrace the fullness of the season that you're in right now. So anyway, I hope you learned something. I hope you this shifted your perspective that being single ain't no bad thing. It's lit. I'm enjoying it. At one point I wasn't, but now I'm like, baby, you can't tell me nothing. Baddie, Fendi's. I'm just kidding. So anyway, I'm just gonna wrap things up. Again, if you think you wanna do less, or I should do a Let's Talk About series, comment some topics below. And I appreciate y'all for tuning in. And till the next video, see y'all.